Midsommar is a story about the shocking adventures of a group of American graduate students who traveled to Sweden to observe the strange rituals of the Horga, a commune in the province of Hälsingland. Christian, played by Jack Reynor, is strongly considering breaking up with Danny, played by Florence Pugh, because he thinks she's too needy. Then, unexpectedly, Danny's sister kills herself and her parents by pumping carbon monoxide into the family home with a tube connected to a car. Danny is devastated, so Christian decides not to break up with her. Meanwhile, Christian and his three grad school friends, Mark, Josh, and Pelle, are planning a trip to Sweden to visit and conduct research on the commune where Pelle was raised. When Danny discovers this, Christian feels obligated to invite her. Upon arriving, the commune members, who call themselves the Horga, welcome them warmly and introduce them to their unusual rituals, many of which are aided by psychedelic drugs. A young British couple is also visiting, Connie and Simon. But the group is in for its first shock. The oldest Horga couple, both of whom have reached 72, kill themselves by jumping off a cliff in a ritual called a testupa. Horrified, Connie and Simon decide to leave. Later, Connie is surprised when a Horga man explains to her that Simon has left ahead of her and is waiting for her at the local train station. Flustered, she gathers her things to leave. However, in the next scene, we hear a woman screaming in the distance. Presumably, it's Connie. Then Mark's sexual interest in Swedish women leads to his death. Inga, a pretty Horga girl, flirts with him, but he's too shy to flirt back. So in a later scene, she leads him away to show him something in the middle of dinner. Mark is then killed, but we never learn how. Meanwhile, Josh treats the Horga people like research objects for his anthropology master's degree thesis. He enters one of their holy buildings and takes pictures of religious documents against their wishes, but he's killed moments later by a Horga man wearing a mask made of Mark's face who vanished earlier. One by one, the visitors disappear until only Danny and Christian remain. The truth is the Horga have been killing them because they need their corpses to celebrate a murderous ritual that occurs only once every 96 years. Danny, however, is unaware of the deaths and has been integrating herself into the commune. She wins a drug-fueled dance competition where she becomes the May Queen. Later, the commune leader pressures Christian to have sex with Maya in order to impregnate her, but their sexual experience is highly ritualized as a group of naked Horga women surround the couple, moaning in unison with Maya. During her May Queen coronation, Danny is whisked away in a carriage pulled by Horga women to bless their crops. But when she returns, she discovers Christian's infidelity by peeking through the keyhole of the room's door. She screams in emotional agony at the sight of her boyfriend having sex. A group of Horga women then hurriedly lead her away, crying and shouting, with her empathetically in show of moral support. As events unfold, Christian finds the dead bodies of his friends and then is drugged against his will, just as he finds Simon's mutilated body suspended from the ceiling of a barn. Finally, the Horga explain to Danny why they have murdered all of their friends except Christian, but they want to kill three more people for a total of 9, a number that's sacred to them. Two Horga men have volunteered. However, as May Queen, Danny must choose the last person to die. It must either be one of the Horga or Christian. Incredibly, she chooses Christian. The movie ends with the Horga burning both the dead and living sacrificial victims in a wooden temple. They empathetically mimic the screaming victims as they burn. Christian, who burns with them, is silent because he has been drugged into paralysis and sewn into a bear skin. The Horga embrace the use of hallucinogenic drugs, as do Danny's friends. In this respect, they're similar, but that's where the similarities end. While Danny's hometown is cold and uninviting, the Horga are warm and welcoming. Christian's friends only tolerate Danny, but the Horga welcome her with open arms and make her their May Queen. Despite the focus on Danny and Christian's relationship, this is a horror movie. Some scenes are shocking and violent. For instance, Christian walks into a barn to discover Simon suspended from the roof face down, with his back cut open and his lungs pulled out. This is an obvious example of the blood eagle, a form of torture mentioned in Viking sagas written in the Middle Ages. The movie's plot line can be seen as a metaphor for Danny's relationship with Christian. The death of the old couple represents the death of her parents. Her acceptance into Horga culture represents her new life without Christian. Also, Christian's death represents the death of the relationship and a better life for Danny in a community that accepts her unconditionally. Director Ari Aster said this is primarily a story about the end of a romantic relationship told on a grand scale. Also, he spent many hours researching Norse rituals that predate modern Scandinavia. The people of Horga engaged in human sacrifice, euthanasia of the elderly, maypole dancing, the usage of love potions, and love spells. All of these were ancient Norse customs, or at least believed to be. Also, every 9 years, the ancient Norse sacrificed 9 people along with groups of 9 animals because 9 was a sacred number to them. Midsommar is Ari Aster's second critically acclaimed film in as many years. Let's see if he can keep up his winning streak in 2020. Thanks for watching my video. If you liked it, please click like and share and subscribe to my channel.